Very happy Father's Day to you, everybody. This is the Stella Artois Grass Court Championships from the Queen's Club in London. It is a historic place, and many historic matches have taken place here. Used to be in the days gone by that they said if you won Wimbledon, if you won Queen's Club, that you didn't have much chance of winning Wimbledon. Well, that has changed in the last decade, as we told you yesterday. Yvonne Lindell is 30 years old. He lives in Greenwich, Connecticut now, born, of course, in Czechoslovakia. For him, Fred, so far it has been a good year.
Yes, well, he's everything with a purpose, Cliff, as far as Wimbledon is concerned. Went down to Australia, practiced in Australia, then went back to the United States for a couple of weeks before coming over here. Fine athlete, he's tuned to perfection at the moment and has got used to the new racket. It took him a while in the Australian Open. He stuck with the racket he'd been using for years. Tony Rhodes suggested that a racket with a little bit larger head might help him on the volley and also on the serve. And I talked to him about the second serve yesterday, and he figures that the larger headed racket has helped in that much, in that department very much so.
Well, that sure is important, especially on grass. Becker's 22 years old. He is a few millimeters, 1 inch taller than the man that he's playing against today, Boris Becker, but he has won 3 Wimbledon titles. For him, Fred, it has been very much an up and down year, more down than up, really.
Yeah, well, he has yet to win a clay court tournament, and I think the surprise exit in Paris may have helped him. We'll find out in another 3 weeks' time, actually, whether he wins Wimbledon, because they have a week's break between now and the start of Wimbledon. The draw, of course, is made midway through the week, and they will be able to practice it on the Wimbledon grass courts as of next Wednesday. So Becker feels that he owns centre court at Wimbledon, whether he owns this one here. He's won the tournament here a couple of times, but this looks like being a tremendous confrontation and a great lead-up to the championships.
He won Brussels over Charlie Steeb. The two have played each other, well, a lot of times. 15 times, as a matter of fact. The last 5 times, Becker has won them all. It's 8-7 overall. Becker won the semi-final match with him at the 88 Wimbledon, and then he won the Masters at Madison Square Garden, also in 88. Beat him again at Wimbledon in 89. Final of the US Open. And the last time they played was the Stuttgart tournament, as you said, on carpet. In that match, it didn't look like Lindell really gave it all.
No. Today is going to be different. As we've talked about, the weather here is absolutely perfect for a final today. The grass court's very hard and very true. Both these fellas like to rifle returns of serve, particularly Becker. Becker just stands back there and slugs all the time. Lindell the same, although Lindell will slice a couple of backhands, but with the true bounce, you can expect a lot of blistering returns today.
Lindell's the number one player in the world. Of course, he's a good player on any surface, but let's take a look at, on grass anyway, what his strengths and weaknesses are.
Well, we've noted down Lindell's strengths, of course, the first serve. He served a lot of aces in that semi-final match with John McEnroe yesterday, and the returner serve. Just tees off early in a match on the returner serve to try and put the incoming volleyer under some pressure. His weaknesses, I think, are on the volleys, although yesterday he volleyed particularly well, and he's really not a natural grass court player, and that's why he has dedicated this year to just getting in shape for one tournament.
How about Becker?
Boris Becker on the other side, what can you say? Serve? Got to be strength. Return a serve, the same thing on grass courts. I wouldn't say that so much on clay, but we couldn't really give him any weaknesses, Cliff, could we? We discussed that, but on grass, what can you say? He may miss a couple of low volleys every now and again, but so does everybody.
I think if you're talking about a clay court surface, for example, you might say, well, if he stays back, then yep, his chances are pretty slim, but on a grass court, you know, he returns serves so doggone well, as you say, Fred, and then he just puts so much pressure. If you miss the first serve against Becker, the second serve, you've really got to go for it. Maybe taking 10% off, you take much more off it, then you're going to be looking at passing shots.
You're looking at passing shots, and also under pressure at times, you're looking at serving a couple of double faults.
Well, what is it? We had a chance to talk to Yvonne Lindell about playing against Boris Becker, and of course, here's what he said about that match.
Well, Boris looks like he's winning out there, and I guess he must be playing well. He broke in the first game, but again, it's great practice, and to play against some of the best players, that's the best practice you can have.
We asked him that question, by the way, just as the second match yesterday was going on. By the way, you know by now, of course, that Edberg won that match. Becker. At least Becker won the match over Edberg. And it was a straight set victory for Boris Becker. One of the big stories of this year has been Ivan Lendl's preparation for Wimbledon. People say, well, he should or he should not have done it. So we posed that question to the man he's playing against today, Boris Becker. That's what he said.
I said it from the first place that it was a good idea. You know, he's won the French Open 3 times. And he doesn't have so many years left, you know, to have a chance at Wimbledon. And this year he had the chance. He was playing a lot and practicing a lot. And he's been playing well here in Queens. So I think he made the right decision.
He certainly has been playing well here at Queen's Club, Ivan Lendl. So, in fact, has Boris Becker. He's had a little tougher time, as we've already told you, getting to the final here. But Ivan Lendl's coach, Tony Roach, Fred, knows a lot about playing tennis on grass.
Well, there's Tony Roach right in the center of your screen. And to his right, his lovely wife, Sue, who arrived over here a couple of days ago. And next to him on Tony's right-hand side there with his hand on his chin is David Graham. And then his wife, Ivan's wife, Samantha. And David Graham has been the man that's been the workhorse. And Jerry Armstrong, the chair umpire there, an experienced man. But Roachie, I think, has taught Lendl a lot. And they were very relaxed. I've just come from the locker room just prior to the players going on court. And Roachie was relaxed. And, oh, we'll be take a couple of days off, play golf. And that's Jerry Armstrong again. And I posed the same question to Bobby Brett. And he said, well, we really haven't decided yet what we're going to do. So Lendl feels confident enough that he wants to have a couple of days rest and then just practice, and maybe Becker feels he has a couple of extra days to do some more work.
Potential pre-Wimbledon final, it really is. The two are probably, in betting parlance anyway, the ones who will make it to the final of Wimbledon. Here's Becker to serve.
That's another interesting thing here, quickly talking about betting for Wimbledon, because the betting shops always have a betting line well prior to Wimbledon. This year, they won't open the betting until after today's match, until they see what's happening here, and then they'll put up a betting line for Wimbledon.
Oh, my goodness.
30 love.
You've seen Boris Becker make many a dive on the grass tennis court, especially. In fact, he'll dive on almost any surface. Sometime.
He does it on purpose, though. He didn't do that on purpose.
Exactly.
On that dry spot there. All the players have grass court shoes. They're wearing the grass court tennis sneakers, which have little sort of pimples on the bottom of them that sort of grip the grass a little bit better, and they do not work on clay courts, but he's on a very dry spot on the court there, where there's not much grass, so it's pretty much dirt.
In fact, this court has held up very well, hasn't it? Gee, it looks good.
40 love.
After 6 days of fierce play on the stadium court, at least. By the time the Wimbledon final rolls around, of course, that stadium court looks very bare and brown. Game point. Best of 3-set final.
First game.
Is there anybody you'd like to hear describe tennis more than him? Lendl to serve. First game for him. On serve. Trailing 1-11.
Love 15.
There's that blistering return of serve that you're going to see a lot of off both players, not only from Becker's racket, but Lendl as well. Fine opening service game from Becker. Lendl was barely able to get his racket on a couple of serves.
Love 13.
And Lendl started off this way yesterday against McEnroe. His first service game, he was down a break point, and he got out of it, the only break point he'd suffered throughout the match. And remember, he has not lost serve in this tournament as yet.
Love 30.
Love 40.
Steffi Graf has shown up for this afternoon's match to get some inspiration, Fred. Is that right?
Well, I think she's looking forward to Wimbledon, also the fast grass courts. Lots of practice. They're out there, able to practice next week. Very important stage here for Yvonne Lendl. He can't let Becker get away this early. Serve and volley tennis, if you're interested in odds. The odds are apparently that even if you're down break points, the odds are still 6-4 with the server.
Deuce.
He was down to luck 40, and he's come back.
Those numbers, of course, are only true of a surface like this, where
exactly.
It's so friendly to the server. Not so on clay.
Well, this will be a big pick-me-up for Lendl going against a man that he knows is favourite for Wimbledon. Impressive volley, but Becker, the experience that he has on grass, he knows that he's just got to plant the foot, and he rolled the backhand down the line.
Becker has said that this is a very different kind of tennis on grass compared to clay, and that when you get your chances, you've got to take them. He's had three in this game and hasn't yet.
Advantage, Becker.
Miss hit took Yvonne Lendl by surprise. He was on his way into the net, and as you can see, he had to kind of backtrack. Watch.
Yeah, he takes the stutter step, and this is a mishit shot, so he's not on balance for this at all. You can see him stretch out there, and that's what caused him to miss.
Break point.
Well, that's an unbelievable volley there on a break point. At times, he would get rather nervous on that one, but he played that one with the great determination and never looked like missing it.
In fact, he played it like a guy who's had a lot of practice on grass.
Yeah.
Deuce.
Advantage, Becker.
Well, this will be, let's see, break point number 5, Fred.
He's certainly given him enough opportunities. That's two double faults. His opening service game.
He will get to see a second serve.
Short tennis you like, you're not going to see a better point than this. A gutsy second serve deep in the corner, rifled return, not the volley where he really wanted it, but a fine attempt at the passing shot, and Lendl right there stood his ground at the net.
Deuce again.
Advantage Lendl.
First ace gives him game point. Make that his second ace. Two double faults.
That's very third.
This match is even at one game more.
Well, that's going to give you a picking up clip, because you know, you go out in a match like this and you know you're playing against the best, and both these players are in great form. You get out of 5 break points in your opening service game.
What impresses me, Fred, is the guy's out there serving the second serve so effectively. I mean, he's in trouble, he whacks the second serve and gets into the net. That's cross court tennis.
Thank you.
That guy hasn't lost a point on his serve in the match yet. Second serve game.
Again, Lendl slapping at the return.
One of his choices is to either try to hit it or slice the return.
40 love.
Of course, if you can't get to a racket too, it doesn't really matter, does it? His first ace. Take a look at that. Row of houses surround this Queen's Club. Somebody's up there taking advantage of her position.
I tell you what, they've got to have a pretty good set of binoculars, so they're not going to see much.
First point that Lendl has won on Becker's serve. This is still game point for Becker. Queen's Club is just outside of the Baron's Court, what they call underground here. Very close to downtown, the centre of London. It is a humid day. Fred, but it could hardly be better for playing tennis on grass. If points don't last long and the sun is out, some breeze, but very little.
Don't get much air conditioning over here in this country, and boy, if you don't have that in a day like today, it gets warm.
Still game point for Becker.
This is a Roach specialty, this shot, because he's taught Ivan Lendl that, and it pays dividends, I think, particularly against Becker. You don't get a good look at Becker's first serve because it's just so tough, so quick. The second serve, you do have an opportunity to vary the return of serve, and the slice return of the incoming volley is a good one.
Open court for the volley, and the passing shot was right at Becker, and he didn't make the volley.
He was looking for that forehand volley. I think he was looking for the backhand down the line. There's the first forehand volley. He closes in around the net. You can see him sort of lean towards that forehand side, and then he has to get back. He doesn't have the shoulder turn. Didn't get that right foot across in front of it.
So Lendl has break point. His first. Serve, and Ivan Lendl has broken on two rather poor volleys from Becker. 2-1, first set. Lendl serving, leading with a break, 2-1.
Love.
He looks awfully fit, Lendl. Compare the two guys, you said, you know, they're an inch of one another as far as height's concerned. Becker looks a bigger man, though, doesn't he? But on the other hand, Lendl looks taller. Well, that one hit the top of the tape.
15-0.
That's what caused Lendl to not get a good timing of the volley. He's lucky to get his racket on it.
Thirty.
Four races for Lendl now, and remember, this is only the fourth game of the match. Becker has won. We showed you in our stats a little earlier that Lendl has, over the week, served more aces than Becker.
40-50.
Concerned, I don't think I've seen him serve this well over a period of a couple of days. I've watched him all week here, and he has served very well. As I said, going into this match here, he has not lost a serve all week. That's just a tremendous stat right there, because it's not as though he's been playing guys that can't play.
Indeed. Now, when the chips are down, so it's the second serve that's going to make the difference with him, and that really seems to me, anyway, that he's going for it and feels confident in hitting it, even break point down. You've seen that in this match already.
15 love.
Lendl now has the luxury of that service break and allows him to really attack, try different things on Becker's second serve, because he can't do much but try and get the ball back into play. Becker gets that first delivery in. There's the stutter step, and this one he just rifles the forehand in very close to the line, but then closes in, and good execution on the forehand volley.
30 love.
Fault.
What? I wonder if Becky's going to have an. He's going to argue about this one. Jerry Armstrong in the check called that one a fault.
What's the chart?
He thought that the linesman called a fault, and I'm surprised that Lendl isn't arguing this with him, Fred, because he did get his racket on the ball.
Yeah, he got his racket on the ball, but the judgment, I don't think he would have got it back. The linesman, and Jerry made the mistake. He thought the linesperson called a fault, and he didn't.
This was a good serve. This is game point here. 40 love, Becker.
There's no reason for Becker to, Lendl to get upset. Situation like that, he's up a break. It's only going to put doubts in his mind. Oh. Tell you what, I wouldn't like to be calling these serves. Both these boys are serving in excess of about 130 miles an hour.
Like 40-50. Under those circumstances, I'd like less to be trying to return them, Fred. You know, sometimes the perception of how a guy is playing is as important as how he's actually playing. Lendl, of course, is playing well anyway, but the rest of the field know or perceive anyway that he's playing well on grass. They don't think he's as vulnerable. I think that's a very important fact, not only for today, but for the big one coming up. Becker holds on, but he's still a breaker served down. It's 3-2 in the first set of this best of three set match.
3-2.
3-2, first set.
Wouldn't it be nice, after having a look at that graphic, see Andres Gomez win his first Grand Slam title? Wouldn't it be nice to see him get up to $1 million in the year in prize money? He's been out there for 10 years, a veteran of the tour, same age actually as Lendl, but has won his first Grand Slam title and a very popular man amongst his peers. He'll be at Wimbledon. He's just having a rest. He plays pretty good grass court tennis. been a quarter finalist there.
15 love to Lendl, 3-2 for Lendl break in the first set.
They're the shots that Becker will not be wanting to miss 2 weeks from now when he hits that fine return and he gets the weak half volley reply around mid-court. They're the chances he was talking about. Once you get those, you must be able to take them.
Again. Heck of a shot there, Fred. Watch the volley from the baseline. Yep.
Good deep volley here, and Becker just rifles this. Half volleys, it just touches the top of the tape, and that caused Lendl to miss the volley, but he may not have made that one anyway.
30-15.
Double fault missed by a good 3 feet. It's double fault number three for Lendl.
So well at the right time, Lendl, hasn't he?
Well, it's a secret on grass. Though. You know, you've got to get that big serve, and you've got to vary it a little bit. Becker looking that one there on the backhand side, and the big servers over the years against Becker, if that bothered Becker, it's been out wide to the forehand. But the problem is, if you don't get it wide enough, then you pay the penalty.
Game point.
First service.
Forehand on those two big first serves.
Sell out crowd here at the Queen's Club.
Leads 4-2.
In London for this final, and the touts again were just all over the show. I mean, I must have been stopped by 8 different guys saying, buy tickets or sell them. I'll do either one. And of course, it's indicative of how interesting this match is for these folks here in London.
Well, Frank Lowe, who's involved with it here, is the president, along with Clive Bernstein, the tournament here, do a fabulous job. As you mentioned, on a day like today, it's impossible to get a seat. Everybody wants to watch this one.
15 love.
Another ace there for Becker.
Becker serving at 2-4, first set, 15 love.
Second ace.
The court is also, as we said, in outstanding shape. David Kimpton is the groundskeeper here. He prepared this centre court. As a matter of fact, he was offered a job by Wimbledon. They offered him more money, but he said he likes this atmosphere here at the Queen's Club.
Well, he wouldn't have as many courts to look after here either, Cliff. I think there's about 10 or 12 here. Well, the net court, both players have been striking the ball so well, and the margin of error has been so little that they've hit it so well. That three or four occasions, they've just ticked the top of the tape. That was another one. Only this time it was for Lendl.
Thirty-fifteen. There's a little more, actually, as you watch this replay, yeah. Fred. Your second serve, there's more on Lendl's second serve than there is on Becker's.
There is. I was just going to say, Cliff, second serve, if you don't get it in the right spot, Lendl never had to move his feet there. He just turned the shoulders and was in the hitting zone and just drilled that forehand. Becker had no chance of seeing that one.
30 all.
Tough one for Becker to volley. The tactics there were to try and move in behind it, slice the return, get it low over the net so the incoming volley, it must volley up. And that gives you an opportunity to either move in, make the volley, or to get set for your passing shot. Secret return of serve on grass or on most surfaces is to try and keep that ball below the height of the net. Anything up around waist high or shoulder high should be dealt with by somebody that volleys well.
That's long, so Becker holds on, but he's still a break down when we come back. Lendl will serve, leading 4-3. He's in trouble for Becker, down a break on grass in the first set against Lendl. Lendl serving at 4-3.
Lendl in isolation with that drive straight at him, and you got to use the backhand grip on that one. The forehand grip can't get through again. Another one straight at him, so that's self-protection. Two rifle shots from Becker.
Match update between the two first serve percentages, as you can see, and 13 winners against 6 in Lendl's favour.
30-50.
Look at the skid marks at Lendl's end there, where he moves in on grass and you take that stutter step to try and go one side or the other. The way they manicure these courts, you can pick up those marks on the court, right on your picture there.
Down the line for the winner. And break, a game point for Lendl.
40-15.
There's the skid marks that we were talking about. As the player serves, he takes two or three steps. The first three steps for a good serve and volley are the most important. You've got to get out of the blocks quickly, just like a sprinter, and then you've got to be able to stop and move left or right to make the volley.
Game ended.
Of course, in a case like that, you don't have to worry about
it. You just keep running forward.
Lendl leads 5-3.
5-3 for Lendl, first set. One break, a serve in the match. Interestingly, Becker has had 5 break points in that game.
Remember, that was yesterday, Cliff, the same thing in the opening service game of the match against McEnroe. Lendl was down a break point, and he never looked like losing serve again for the rest of the day.
And Lendl's broken once. In the game that he broke, Becker was up 40 love.
Love 15.
That slice backhand again, paying dividends. If you can keep it low, get it away from the incoming volley, make him stretch and play it below the height of the net, you then have a pretty good chance of winning the point if you get in position to hit a passing shot. Is that good a return then? Becker made the error on the volley.
Love 15. Lendl's one game away from winning the first set.
Oh, on the line.
Becker doesn't like the call.
Love 30.
But he's not going to argue anymore.
Big serve and a rifled backhand down the line. Found the chalk. Becker now starting to press a little bit on serve. Knowing full well that if he doesn't get a decent second serve in, it's going to be dealt with severely by Lendl.
First chance that Lendl got to break, he broke. That was the only break of this first set. As we've said, no breaks for Becker, but as we said, he had five break point opportunities in the first game that Lendl served.
Again, putting a lot of pressure on that first serve, trying to overhit it.
It's a set point. He's broke Becker twice. He wins it 6-3. We'll be back. Clay court tennis is so different from grass court tennis. The French Open was so open. Wimbledon, well, that's not true. And we asked Becker about it.
If they would have more tournaments on grass, you know, you would see more players having a chance to win maybe Wimbledon. But since you only have, you know, two tournaments before Wimbledon, you know, not many players get the chance to play well on grass, and so you more or less see every year just the same players going into the semifinals in Wimbledon.
So it's the same players pretty much, and of course that's how things have worked out. It looks like the same thing is going to happen this year.
Second set, Lendl to serve.
Ivan Lendl very much now a contender for Wimbledon, so of course is Boris Becker, Stefan Edberg as well. They're the big three. Lendl serving first game, second set.
Interesting, just a personal opinion on that. They have just 4 weeks of grass court tennis pretty much now, but they happen to be the four most important weeks of the year in many respects. Wimbledon still regarded as the most important of the Grand Slam titles. That's no slight on the USTA or any of the Grand Slam championships, but for over 100 years, Wimbledon has been the big one. Really, your career is judged by how you do at Wimbledon, then the US Open, then maybe the French, and then finally the Australian. So it's a shame that just 4 weeks gives you just 3 or 4 weeks to get prepared for such an important event.
Game point, Lendl, first game, second set. Twice. Because I think Wimbledon used to be head and shoulders above the other tournaments, Red, but the US Open has caught up to a large extent, so has the French Open. The Australian has got a little way to go, but with its new stadium at Flinders Park, it is catching up. Game point.
You heard Ivan Lendl say higher. That means the ball toss a little low. He wants it up so he can reach right up. Full extension of the arm.
Ivan Lendl is looking fearsome. He has won the first set and the first game of the second set. Becker won them all. Overall, he leads the head-to-head 8-7.
15 love.
Ace number 3 for Becker. Boy, you're not going to see a backhand drive hit any harder than this one.
15-0.
Serve goes back. He jams him on the return, but goes back there. Look at this backhand. Boy, that hurt you.
15-0.
Well, if there were any doubts, Cliff, about him changing rackets, and there was for a time, he practiced a lot with this new frame, was not happy with it, was not confident, but when he didn't play a tournament, he just went out and just dedication.
Yeah,
keeping scores, making sure that Jerry Armstrong doesn't lose track of things. If he does, you can look. Official, as you can see, of the championship. So watching Boris Becker try to hold serve here. First with serve game of the second set.
Whether he's keeping score or doing the caricatures for next year's poster.
Oh. They came up with some unique ones here.
They're fabulous, aren't they?
Yeah.
Impressive stuff. Look where he is to return that serve. He's inside the baseline, moves forward on that slice backhand, doesn't try to drive it, just positions the ball well down the line, close to the line. That forces the incoming volleyer to really stretch.
21 winners for Ivan Lendl now in this match. 21. Becker has 8. I mean, that's in 10 games of play. This is the 11th.
Becker's first serve percentage has gone way down, Cliff. We've said 50%. And that's what's given Lendl the slight edge at the moment.
That's why. There's a break point for Lendl.
30-40.
He's just not able to generate much with the second serve, where he's not trying to put enough on it. So every time Becker misses a first serve, and as we said, that's happening a lot this afternoon, Lendl is all over it. Crucial point in the match, Lendl leading one set and one game to love. Break point.
Very few unforced errors, has missed even fewer returns, and has kept the pressure on the Wimbledon title holder all the way through.
Makes a big difference too how this match turns out, Fred. As we've said, the last 5 times they've played, Becker's won them all. So there's a kind of a psychological edge that you gather by doing that. Gather on grass 2 weeks or 3 weeks before a possible Wimbledon final. Lendl's countryman, or country person, Steffi Graf is watching.
Becker's country.
Becker, excuse me.
Well, they're getting pretty close now. The unification of East and West, and, you know, Czechoslovakia may be there shortly too.
First service.
That's a great shot from Beck. I tell you, he had to play that point very well because the second serve again of Lendl's was hit with such authority.
15-0.
And this volley's not a bad volley either. It allows Becker to get ready for that passing shot. He was under all sorts of pressure to make it.
21 winners and 8 unforced errors only from Lendl, and Becker's number's not near as fearsome. I mean, 21 winners, Fred.
Most
it's really remarkable.
Most of them come from return of serve, though. Outright winners off the second serves and off some volleys. He's been very good at the net today, Lendl. Best I've seen him.
And another eight. That's 8 aces for Lendl. I have a feeling with him, too, that this is not just a flash in the pan. I mean, this is something that he's worked toward that and that he expects.
Dave Lendl.
Ivan Lendl won the first set 6-3 and leads it 3 games to love.
Leads 3 games to love. Second set.
I just don't think he can come back, Fred, at this point. I think Lendl's serving too well.
Unbelievably well today. 9 aces today. Thrown in a couple of double faults, but when you get your game plan set that way, pick up those cheap points, you tend to serve a couple of doubles.
And even a point like that, Becker wanted it, of course, but Lendl threatened him because he had a swing at the passing shot off the return. Pretty low.
40 low.
Beck is serving into the sun from where he is now. Looks like he's been playing on grass all his life at this point.
Yeah, there's that off backhand slice again. Just angles it away from the incoming volley.
Leads 3 games to 1.
So Boris Becker has broken his duck, to use a cricketing parlance, which might be appropriate since we're here in cricketing country, meaning he has opened his score in the second set. 3 games to 1 for Lendl. Lendl won the first.
Not much you can do when Lendl's serving like this.
Becker's looking at the lines person, but it was clearly an ace. Is that 10 now?
10, yeah.
Aces, among other things, for Ivan Lendl, so his serving statistics are really extraordinary. Some resignation in that swing of Becker's.
Well, it's just too much pace on the volley. He's not getting a chance to set up on that passing shot. Lendl's picked up the pace on not only on the second serve, but also in the volleying department. And that's just what he's been missing the last couple of years. And he was very close in his semi-final match last year.
The Wimbledon draw will come out next week, so will of course the Wimbledon seedings, and the result of this match will affect that to some extent. Wimbledon do not do their seedings entirely based on the IBM ATP computer rankings. They're the only tournament in the world who do not. So there's some speculation as to who'll be the number one seed, with Becker of course having won it last year and Lendl never having won it. Ivan Lendl holds on. It's 4-1 to him in the second set. He won the first. The seedings will come out, so will the draw, and one wonders just how important it is on a surface like this, of course, for the great Wimbledon championships. It is important, and we asked both Boris Becker and Ivan Lendl how they saw it.
I think draw is, it is important and it isn't. If you want to win, you have to play well and beat some good players. Of course, you can be a little luckier have a favorable draw where the players which are better than others are packed into one section, and you have section with other players who are also good and great players, but you either like playing them or they're not as good as the others.
Just out of my angles of my eyes, I watch a little bit.
The sides,
yes.
He's really something, isn't he?
I asked him if he looked at the draw, and he said, just out of the corner of my eyes, but I can tell you he's fully well aware of what's going on in that situation.
It's interesting, the difference between the personalities of these two fellas. Yep. As you look at Boris Becker, there's a very warm, gentle side to him. There's a vulnerable side to him as well. Ivan Lendl's a very different, admirable, of course, in his own way, but he is an artisan. I mean, he's out there, he's working toward this Wimbledon title. Everybody knows it, and there is some humor in it, but a different kind of humor.
It's very relaxed this week, and as you mentioned earlier, Cliff, there's a lot of people that know that he has dedicated the last 4 months to the next couple of weeks. That's a better volley.
Well, the point is, Fred, that the other players know that, and when you get out there against him and you know how single-minded he is, it's a different thing when he's just played the French Championships, he's come over, he may not be playing that well. Well, now he is, and everybody knows it. That puts pressure on 127 other players in the Wimbledon field. 15 love.
By another slice return here. Look how low that is, and now this gives him an opportunity. It's an excellent volley from Becker, very deep. Becker closes in, and he thought the ball was going to go long. There it is, off the shoelaces again, and moves in for the volley. You can see him thinks, no, I'm going to let that go.
You're right, you know, Fred, he could have hit that overhead, actually. He did judge it to be going long. I wondered at the time, and you know, watching it, whether it was just out of reach, but it wasn't. 15 all.
One of the very few times Becker's hit a second serve that Lendl's had a look at, and Lendl's missed it. Didn't miss it by much. But, Becker just clawing his way here just to try and stay in this second set. He's only down one service break at 4-1.
A more natural swing or a more natural movement toward the net after his service swing than does Lendl. You could see it there, but that hasn't happened Lendl at all.
Four aces to Becker, and Lendl's cracked 11 of them. That's nearly three times as many. How often have you seen a match where you thought that that might happen with these two boys?
You could have fooled me. This is game point. To me, what you just saw is worse news for Becker. As you watch this replay again, when he misses the first serve, Lendl has just been punishing him on the second.
Been mixing it up well, though, Cliff. That one he decided to drive through the ball. He was still around the service line, so Becker's got to have a look when he goes to hit that second serve and say, well, is he going to drive this or is he going to slice it? He's going to play the chip.
Still game point. Even
advantage, Becker.
Not a good sign. Becker talking to himself. He knows that he's missed a lot of first serves here today.
Cheers.
Wasn't going overhead, or maybe I'll understand what he's saying, but I couldn't pick it up.
You speak a little
German. Yeah, I do. That's why I said I might have had to pick up a few. I don't speak it that well, by the way.
Advantage Becker.
That speaks for itself. 5-8.
Motion. We've seen it on many occasions. He says, yes, okay, I've finally found a first serve.
now is his problem when he misses the first serve. Watch this.
Where Lendl is.
Yeah. Game back up.
Had the opportunity to make the passing shot and just missed it. Zabeka holds on. It's 4-2.
Lendl leads 4-2.
Ola hats in the crowd. It's a festive crowd. It's a beautiful afternoon here in London. And when the weather is great in Western Europe, of which Britain, of course, is now a part, and the days are just wonderful. Soft, gentle kind of days. Kind of days that tennis should be played on grass.
And everybody around the place should have a pint in their hand or a Pimm's.
This is the big testing moment for Ivan Lendl. As yet in this entire tournament, he has not lost his serve, and that's one of the very few backhand return winners that Becker has hit today. Lendl checking the ball toss, the position of the sun.
Love 15. And Becker looking a little more lively than he has been with this opportunity.
No! 15-0.
That's been the difference today on return of serve. Lendl has been just so sure of himself when he gets a look at that second serve. Becker not so.
He's trying to cover the backhand.
Can't pick the serve. Lendl's done a great job of mixing the serve up today.
Says a lot for a guy's serve when your opponent has to move before you ever hit the ball.
12 aces.
30-15.
Biggest opportunity so far for Becker, 30-all, second serve.
Well, in a long time anyway, Fred. First game he had all kinds of choices.
40-30.
Game point for Lendl to go up 5-2. He won the first set, 6-3. An errant volley, Fred, but that's the first one in a long time.
Yeah, the first volley wasn't as decisive as he has been, and it allowed Becker to have a second crack on the passing shot. Deuce.
Advantage, Lendl.
Comes back with a big serve when needed again.
Fire! Dave Lendl.
Lendl holds on, and a rather disconsolate Boris Becker goes to the sidelines. It's 6-3 and 5-2 for the world's number one. From Lendl, but he just wasn't there in enough time. Watch this again.
15.
He gets this one. Now look where Lendl is. Becker gets to it. He's on the ground. But now watch where that ball is compared to where Lendl was before, and he runs it down. But just not in enough time to do anything with it. Here's Becker's effort in isolation. Big move to keep him in this game. It's 15-4. And now 15-30.
15-30.
So much trouble when he misses his first serve, Becker. And as we have been following his first serve percentages, they just have not been good enough for him. Game point for Becker. Treating his second serve with consummate ease. Look at this. Threatening him every time he misses the first serve. He has made, given Becker almost no free points. Made him play every volley, and sometimes he hit the clean winner like he did on that last return. Deuce. Becker trying to take a little bit off the first serve to avoid having to serve a second serve, and that didn't work either because Lendl was looking for that one, and this is match point. For the Wimbledon seeding committee, doesn't it? It also answers those critics who said that Ivan Lendl was not doing the right thing by concentrating on his grass court game. His grass court game today was no less than terrific. He has destroyed the Wimbledon champion, West Germany's Boris Becker, in straight sets, two serve breaks in each set. Becker wins it, or Lindell rather wins it, by 6-3 in the first set, and then 6-2. We'll be back. Ivan Lendl over Boris Becker in straight sets, 6-3 and 6-2. Boris Becker in the match served 8 times and was broken 4 times. Now that's remarkable stuff from Ivan Lendl, the number one player in the world. And he is at courtside now with our own fiery one, Fred Stolle. Fred?
Ivan, just a tremendous effort again today. You must be quite happy with the way things are.
Of course, Fred, any time you win the tournament, you should be happy. And especially the way I played throughout the whole week, I didn't lose my serve once. And I was breaking very often. And to break Boris 4 times in 2 short sets is very good.
The only time you had trouble with your serve yesterday, the opening service game against John. Today, 5 break points in the opening service game. You survived, and that's when it all started on the return.
Felt like 12 or 15 break points, but I think it has to do a little bit with timing. Every time you walk on the court, you need to get timing, and it takes me a little longer on my serve, no matter how hard I warm up and how well I hit them in the knockout before the match. It still takes me a game or two before I get my rhythm.
I spoke to Tony about the new racket. He feels that that is helping the second serve. He got a little bit more zip on that, but also the volleys. You really volleyed well today.
Well, any mid-size or oversized racket is going to be better for volleys than regular size racket. And the whole key to that is to find a racket that weights, balances, tensions and flexibilities that you can hit off the ground also, and we think we found that.
Well, you're about the only one, because two or three of the other boys haven't been able to find that yet.
Which ones?
Well, Boris is still using the same racket. He hasn't seemed to be able to fall.
Yeah. Well, I have to thank Mizuno for that, because I'm very demanding in terms of my products. Way I use them, and the slightest little thing, basically anything I say they just do, and it just helps, because many times you go into a dead-end street with rackets and shoes and clothes, and it helps if they still show confidence in you. If they say, oh heck with it, he doesn't know what he wants, we don't do it anymore. For example, what happened, I had a racket, the one I'm using right now, and I didn't like it at first, and I had one which was less powerful and a little less flexible, and I was using that, and then all of a sudden I said, okay, let's try the other one. I had only one of those, and I liked it better because I got used to the power, to the size, and so we caught up. Well, in 48 hours we had 12 more rackets, and if you have that cooperation, it's easier. It's never easy, but I have to thank them for that.
Today, the returner serve, you mixed up the returner serve on the backhand side, particularly the second court, moving forward on the slice backhand. Are you going to continue that? That's something you worked on with Rochi?
Well, I feel Boris's serve comes that high, so high that it's hard to get over. I would love to mix it up even more, where I sometimes come over, sometimes I slice it, but if I have no choice, I have to slice.
What are you going to be doing next week in the preparation before Wimbledon starts?
Play lots of golf.
You take Rochi's money?
I think he's retired for a while.
He's too many four putts.
Yeah, too many four putts, and his family came over today, so I think he will spend some time with them.
Well, it's a shame that Drysdale's going home. You can't take his money. Congratulations and good luck.
Yeah, but you can tell him if he played with me, he would have lost. So you and I have a dinner on him then.
Okay. Thanks very much, Ivan. Appreciate it.
See you.
Well, I'm not sure that would have happened. You can have dinner on me anyway. Of course, the Rochi that they're talking about, or Tony, you put those together, that is Tony Roach, one of the great players of all time, the man who also coaches Ivan Lendl and has coached him in his effort to try to win Wimbledon for the first time. Remember, Ivan Lendl has tried 10 times in the past and have never succeeded, but he has never looked better, and we'll be talking to Tony Roach when we come back. The world's number one, Ivan Lendl over Boris Becker, 6-3, 6-2, and Ivan Lendl's coach, Tony Roach from Australia, is with another Australian, our own Fred Stolle. Fred?
Thanks, Cliff. I'm with Coach Roach, and Roachy, Ivan's not too kind to your golf game.
Well, we have some tight struggles, but he's always working on me on the putting green, and he seems to get through me. So if I can fix up my putting, I'd be okay. But he's actually playing good golf. He's playing off 9, and I'm off 16. But you know, I always thought when you played golf that you're supposed to get strokes when the handicaps are different, but he doesn't give you anything.
Yeah, well, he's a bit like that. He must be seeing the golf ball like a tennis ball, but he's seeing the tennis ball like a football.
Yeah, he's. I think this last week has been as consistent that I've ever seen him play on grass. I mean, he's served and volleyed well, and he's returning serve as well as I've seen.
He's dedicated his entire year to Wimbledon. Let's go through what's happened. He went down to Australia, what, 6 weeks ago to start off with?
In the middle of April he came down after he got over his bout with chicken pox. And it was the first time that he used the Mizuno racket. He wanted to try the larger headed racket. And we put in some grass courts at the resort, and we spent 2 weeks there working hard and training, and we were lucky enough to get Newcomb and Rosewall to come up and play an exhibition with him. So he got a little
bit of confidence.
Yeah, he got a little bit of confidence there from Nuke. But we spent 2 weeks there, and then of course he went back for the birth of Marika, and I went over a week later, and we continued working in Greenwich, just down the road from his house. There's some tennis courts, grass courts, and we spent about 2.5 weeks there before coming over here.
Did you work on anything physical in Greenwich, or just basically hitting tennis balls on grass?
No, we split up the sessions. In the morning sessions we do a lot of drills that are closely associated with match play, and that was to get him to more or less think more about where he should play a ball and what he should do. And also, you know, moving on the court, his movement and balance, speed work. And then in the afternoons he'd play match play. We had David Graham there, a young Australian kid who, you know, was a great help to us. And then, of course, he would get on the bike and after 4 hours on the court and do his work on the bike, you know, for the hard physical side.
Yeah, and then you came over here. You've been here for 3 weeks. Everything seems to have worked out well, and you've settled in, and everything's a lot more comfortable than it was, say, in the last 3 or 4 years.
Well, it's been an entirely different build-up. You know, as everybody knows, that Ivan has played the French prior to going into Wimbledon. And, you know, he's done well there without winning the title, but he's been in two finals and a couple of semi-finals. And he just felt that with the extra practice on grass, it may make the difference. I mean, who's to know? But so far, everything's falling into place.
Well, both Ivan and Boris really don't care too much about the draw. What do you think about the draw?
No, I don't think. I've always said to Ivan, you know, you've got to beat all the good players to win it. And, I mean, he's ready, and I don't think there'll be any excuses from Ivan if he doesn't win.
Do you think he can win?
Oh, yeah, I think he can win. I think a big thing happened last year when he really had Boris on the ropes and had chances to win. And to Boris's credit, I think the break in the weather there, he was down a break in the fourth set, but he was good enough to, Becker was good enough to get out of that hole, and you need a little bit of luck to win Wimbledon. You need some things to go right for you, and it happened for Boris, and you've got to be good enough to take advantage of that. And so, yeah, I think Ivan's good enough to win it, but so are a lot of other guys.
Well, thanks, Tony. Thanks for being with us, and good luck, Wimbledon.
Okay, thank you, Fred.
Back to you, Cliff.
Thank you very much, Fred. You know, I am a convert now. As far as I'm concerned, Ivan Lendl has done the right thing in his effort to win Wimbledon. It shows in the way that he's playing here at the Queen's Club. He is the winner here over Boris Becker by 6-3 and 6-2. He said he didn't want to ever wake up not feeling that he'd given it his best. He doesn't have to worry about that. Ivan Lendl, the winner of the Stella Artois Grass Court Championships from the Queen's Club, part of the IBM ATP Tour, and Fred Stolle, from a statistical standpoint, it was a wonderfully played match by Ivan Lendl.
Unbelievable, Cliff, the return of serve and the serve. The percentages on serve, not too good for both players. Lendl would like to be up around 60%. Becker there at 48%, Lendl only at 51%. But 12 aces to 5. The big thing, though, 34 winners to 14. And that's incredible on a grass court in just over, you know, two sets that took just about an hour and 15 minutes. And he broke the Becker serve on four occasions. So Lendl's gone through the tournament without having lost his serve. And it really hasn't hurt him, the fact that he's in the doubles final here either. So he's playing in the doubles final. He wants all the stuff, all the grass court gear he can get.
And he has taken, as you said, every opportunity to play as much on grass. And it shows in his results. Let's take you to the ceremonies here at the Queen's Club. It is a really a wonderful, spectacular setting for a tennis tournament. Queen's Club, not far from the center of London, of course, as Boris Becker comes out, acknowledges the applause of the crowd. He will accept from the Duchess of Gloucester the runner-up check for his week's work here at the Queen's Club.
Well, he's had a pretty good week too. I think he needs just to go out and work on the serve. Bobby Brady's Australian coach will have him doing that. I saw him there. That I feel that Becker, if he picks it up 10%, is still in there with a big shot. But here's the winner.
The man who, as we've said, has dedicated his entire year to winning the Great Wimbledon Championships, which will start on Monday week. The seedings and the tournament draw will all be made this coming week. And Yvonne Lendl, of course, is hoping, as he said, to be seeded either one or two. After his efforts today, Fred, there's no doubt that he'll be the top seed at Wimbledon.
Well, you'd think so, Cliff, but they may go along with Becker because he won the US Open and Wimbledon last year. But as long as both of them are one and two, it doesn't make that much difference. But then the most important thing is the toss of the coin to see where three and four go in that draw, because three and four probably will be Stefan Edberg at three and possibly John McEnroe at four, but that's an estimated guess at the moment, and I don't think that may happen.
And again, of course, there's Andres Gomez, who won the French Championships, and he indeed may be number four, which might make John McEnroe something more of a floater in the field. Those questions, of course, will all be answered during this next week here in England. Yvonne Lendl, as we said, has geared his entire year to winning Wimbledon, and we had a chance to talk to him about it. The other tournaments don't mean that much, but Wimbledon is everything.
I didn't come here to try to win in Beckingham. Of course, it's nice if I do it, and that's part of the early preparations plan, but everything is geared towards Wimbledon and playing better on grass, and that's why we put the schedule together like we did.
The schedule included playing on grass in Australia, playing on grass in the northeastern part of the United States near his home in Connecticut, and now, Fred Stolle, these warm-up tournaments to Wimbledon itself.
Well, as we've mentioned so many times, it's very important here at Queen's to win this event. It goes through your mind. It's just a confidence builder. You know you've put a lot of work into it. Boris Becker realises he has to go out and do a bit more work on the serve next week. So Lendl will golf for two or three days, and I think Boris Becker will get out there with Bobby Brett and try and work on that big serve.
He's going to have to, because he was broken four times in eight serve games against the world's number one, Yvonne Lendl. We'll be back with more of our coverage from the Queen's Club in London in just a moment.